Namaste friends and welcome back to Family Recipe Ghar. Today we are going to make a delicious yummy thick gravy called Sicily. For this we would require 200 grams of paneer that has been cubed and boiled, 2 to 3 tablespoons of maida, 3 chopped green chilli, half a cup of milk with half a cup of water mixed, 1.5 inches of ginger that has been chopped, 8 to 10 pods of garlic chopped, 2 to 3 onions finely chopped, 2 tablespoons of butter. We have used homemade butter, but you can also use a salted variety or unsalted variety from the market which is available. Amul butter goes really well with this. About 2 teaspoons of kasuri methi, 1 teaspoon of pepper, and 2 slices of processed cheese. It is better if you use cubes of cheese. It will be easier to shred into the curry and goes well with it. But it's the lockdown period and we can't get our hands on any processed cubes of cheese. So we're using sliced. Salt as per taste. Let's begin to make the curry now. In a pan, we have melted our butter. And now we're going to add the chopped onions into it. Fry it until it becomes a little soft and slightly brown. Now we have sauteed this onion for about 3 to 4 minutes. When it becomes to become a little soft and pinkish, start adding ginger, garlic and the green chilies. Sort again till it becomes a little more incorporated into each other. So our onions are ready now. You can see that they have taken on a slightly golden brown tinge. Now is the time to add our maida into this mixture. Now on low flame, incorporate the maida into the onion, garlic, ginger mixture such that it becomes a little roasted. Once it roasts, like maybe about after a minute or two, switch off the flame. Sort the maida into the mixture even when the flame is off. And now slowly start adding the milk and water mixture that we had kept ready into this. Gradually go on adding and turning the ladle along with it so that the maida gets dissolved into the milk. If you require to add more milk or water, feel free. So now that the maida has completely dissolved into the milk and water mixture, you can relight the flame of the gas and then start to add pepper according to taste or 1 teaspoon, salt, kasuri methi crushed, and pieces of cheese into it. Now add the cheese little by little. You can tear it into smaller pieces so that it dissolves into this mixture faster. But if it were a cube, it would have been easier because you could directly grate it into the curry. So now the gravy has started to thicken a little bit like this. So if you want to keep it a little more light and gravy-like, you could add a little more mixture of milk and water. Else, you can even do this adjustment when you're serving finally and you're heating it. You could add a little warm water and milk together and make it a little more watery like this. This goes better. Now we're going to add our paneer cubes into it and leave it to cook for about 2 to 3 minutes. As long as the paneer starts to absorb all the flavor of the gravy around. So while our gravy is boiling, we would like to tell you that this is slightly bland. It's not a very spicy or chatpata curry like our Indian curries. But it is, like you've already seen, it contains paneer, cheese, milk. So it's great for kids. And because it's slightly bland too, I think they would love it. Usually goes well with garlic naan, or the best combination is with garlic bread. So generally either you can buy garlic bread made in stores, or you can use bread and smear it with this Amul garlic spread, or even make homemade garlic butter, which is basically to do with just melt a little bit butter, add chopped garlic into it and let it absorb the flavors for a while, and then add it onto the smear it onto the bread and roast it on a tawa. So have fun making this curry. We definitely did, and I hope you definitely try it. Like, share and subscribe recipes on Family Recipe Ghar, and love to cook for you. Thank you.